What's up? It's your boy Austin Rutherford back here again. I don't know if you've been paying attention, but there's been a lot of government stimulus plans. And one of those things is called the PPP, the Paycheck Protection Program. And what it is basically, it's a loan from the government to individual business owners to help try and keep people employed and on payroll instead of everybody filing for unemployment. So recently, earlier this week, they released an update to the PPP program. And President Trump finally officially signed that into law here earlier this week. And these updates can massively affect small business owners. A lot of the changes are for the benefit of a small business owner, because in the PPP program, what it does is it can be a forgivable loan. It can be forgiven, meaning you don't have to pay it back if used the proper way. And that's what we're talking about here today, is the changes that was made and how to use it properly so you can actually get that money forgiven. And if you have not yet received your PPP loan, or if you've applied for it, if you're still waiting for it, or if you have not even applied for it yet, according to the Independent Community Bankers of America, they're saying the latest that you can still apply for a PPP loan and get a PPP loan is June 30th, 2020. So if you have not yet gotten it, you might want to listen to this video and stick around so you can learn the ins and outs, and so you may even be able to still apply for one. As always, with any government program out there, there continues to be changes to this program. They put it out in such a hurry when this whole COVID-19 hit, there had to be changes to it. So this is the change that just happened, and I'm sure there's going to be changes that continue to happen, and clarification from the SBA, the Small Business Administration, and the Treasury on how these funds can be used. As of right now with this new legislation, the changes are as follows. So when it first dropped, it said that we had 8 weeks. If you received that loan, the PPP loan, you had 8 weeks to use that money in the proper ways, which we're going to cover here in a second. They extended that to 24 weeks. So you have 3 times the amount of time to use that money to hopefully get that money forgiven and not make it a loan that you have to pay back. Another part of this PPP program was, when it was first released, was that 75% of the loan amount had to be used towards payroll. The small business owner had to use 75% of the loan amount to pay payroll to their employees. So if you got a $10,000 loan, $7,500 in the next 8 weeks would have to be used to pay payroll. Now they reduce that amount to 60%. So 60% of what the money you receive has to be used towards payroll. And they went from 8 weeks to 24 weeks. So you have way more time to spend less money on payroll. The other monies can be used for rent, for utilities, office expenses a little bit, but mostly rent and utility and interest payments. What it also did is, previously, if you did not spend 75% on payroll, the whole loan was a loan and none was forgiven. This is not an end-all be-all now. 60% has to be used on payroll, but if you don't hit 60%, let's say you only use 50% on payroll, then the loan will be adjusted down, the forgiven part of the loan will be adjusted down, and a small portion will still be owed as a real loan. But it's not an end-all be-all. If you don't hit all of the requirements, and you hit some of them, or you come short of some of them, that portion can still potentially be forgiven. Another thing is that it replaces the 6-month deferral of payments due under the PPP until the date that the SBA actually pays the lender the amount of the loan to forgiveness. Another change to it, loans made before June 5th had a 2-year maturity line. So if it was not forgiven, you had 2 years to pay this loan back. What it changed, though, now it's a 5-year maturity date. So if you got your loan before June 5th, you're still on the 2-year. If you got it after June 5th, you're on the 5-year, but they opened up some leeway where you can go back to the bank that gave you the money in the first place and try and negotiate to that 5-year term and not the 2-year term that you were started on. And this was according to the Independent Community Bankers of America. Another thing that it changed is that it eliminated provisions that make PPP loan recipients who have PPP debt forgiven ineligible to defer payroll tax payments. Like I said, this is not an end-all be-all. With any government type of loan or type of program, there's always going to be changes that continue to come forward. So I don't want you to think like this is set in stone, but this is where it stands right now today. So we're basing our business and our loan forgiveness and our PPP loan on the facts that we have today and going by that. And if changes come in the future, we'll tweak and adjust and pivot at that point. And like I said at the beginning of this, if you did receive a PPP loan, if you follow this new guidance from the SBA and the Treasury, then you could have a higher probability of actually getting this loan forgiven. And forgiven means free. It's free money that you do not have to pay back. If used improperly and not abiding by these terms, then that can turn into a loan that you actually have to pay back to the government. Hopefully this brought some clarification to the subject. I know it's an ever-changing situation, so we're going to continue to drop videos as new updates come out. So make sure you hit that subscribe button, hit that like button below so you can get all the notifications going forward and you can stay on top of any of the changes in the future. Appreciate you guys being here, and until next time.